Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Darkest Dungeon adventure here in week 93. I will say that I did have another episode recorded before this one was recorded. I decided to not publish that one. It wasn't really a fun episode, and it was basically just a medium run through the coves. Lots of really terrible RNG, standard stuff. And, like, there was nothing really amazing that happened. I mean, like, Invicta was our stress healer since we couldn't have any... we did not have any jesters that could go for the party comp that I had, and yeah, it wasn't the greatest. So we're sitting at 25,000 gold right now, and yeah, we're still working. The Warrens and the Cove they're both actually even with 70%. We need to make sure that we get our progress bar up to level 7 so we can unlock the bosses, so we can get this done and then pretty much just go towards the end of the game, which is going to be the Darkest of Dungeons, which is this one right here. So we gotta go either to the Warrens or the Cove. There's a short one or a long one inside of the Warrens, or we could go for another short one in the Cove. I would love to get another moon ring. Moon rings would be, they're very beneficial for doing a bunch of dark runs. So I think we're gonna go to a short one in the Cove. By the way, I brought Ken there just so we could actually level him up. He did level up. As you see, judging from the amount of stress that we had, yeah, that's basically what happened on that run. So we just need to do a good old short run here, and obviously we're going to want to take a plague doctor to get rid of the bleeds. I think that honestly we go for Sept. Let's go Sept, Kate, because I believe that she has Cove scouting. Cove stress damage. Crendoge, he's the only plague doctor that can go right now. And then we need lots of power in the back line. We don't have to have a jester for this. We could bring Davis. What does Davis have? Davis or Frag? I'm gonna bring Frag. And I tell you what. Davis will go ahead and lock in. Oh man, we gotta get rid of Calm too. I didn't realize he still had that. So we're gonna pay 12,500 gold to lock in Faded. And to get rid of Calm. Why did it take me so long to get rid of Calm? I probably could have actually done that in here if we'd found an eerie coral, but yeah, it's okay. All right, so up front we're gonna have Sept, and let's give him the tough ring. And this is gonna be probably a dark run, I would guess. So we can give him more dodge, or he actually needs some dodge. Let's think about this. Do we want to go for an invasion tank, or do we want to go for just more HP, just raw HP? I think I'm going to try... to up his evasion. So, we need to get just dodge. Again, since we are going to be doing a... Since we're doing a dark run, I mean, I'm not going to buy any torches for this. We shouldn't need it, but... We'll go for a moon cloak for Sept. Do we want to go for moon cloak? I could just give him... Honestly, I could just give him Wilbur's flag. He gets 10 dodge from that alone, and then we could also give him... I need another highwayman so I can do this party composition I've been theory crafting, and I haven't had a chance to do it yet. Yeah, we'll just do Mooncloak. That's fine. Actually, I don't want to get limited. Whoops, I don't want to get limited by the torchlight. So let's just get more HP. That's fine. That's fine. Up front, we'll give Kate the Profane Scroll and Sacred Scroll, Crendoge, Blasphemous Vial, as well as Poison Herb, and then Frag will give him the Fusion's Matchstick, as well as do we want to give him 20%? Let's give him more damage. Where's Dismas' head? There we go. Yeah, so that's a lot of damage the Frag is going to be packing. And let's just make sure everyone's good to go. Kate's good. Sept is good. Crendor's good. And Frag is also good. All right. Easy enough. Let's go ahead and do it. So it's going to be a short run on the Cove here. I bring two shovels just in case we get a chest. We are looking to get a... hopefully some decent amount of gold here. I'm not gonna bring any torches, like I said. I don't think we're gonna need any holy water. Anti-venom is barely used in the cove as is. I'm taking a little bit of a risk here. I should just get full personal stack. There's really no excuse. I mean, food is so cheap, especially if you, even if you have a little bit of gold, it far outweighs the consequence of not having food when you need it.
The smell of rotting fish is almost unbearable.
So we've got to go... We have to go... Basically... We can skip one room in here. So we don't have to do either of these if we don't want to. I think we should.
Masterfully executed.
Friend Doge, you're going to start out with a crit. Now you might be wondering why I brought Kate, since she already has 36 stresses. Because we can use Frag if we have to. To do some stress damage. Oh my goodness, Frag. 26 damage. Out of nowhere. So here comes the Slice and Dice and Sept and Kate. Sept, I'm gonna go ahead. We'll go ahead and have him. I'm not gonna guard Kate here. We shouldn't need that. Point blank shot, it gets riposted. Yes. Wow, Kate. Everyone's just critting all over the place right now. I mean, I'm not gonna complain about it. It's surprising. I like it, team. It's a far cry from that last episode, that's for sure. Yeah, alright, so he is done. Slowly, gently. Could go for a stun if we wanted to here. I think that, I think I'm just gonna go for a crush. And miss completely. So, and then of course he goes, alright, after Kate. She did not get bled from it, though. Even if she did, Krendor would have been able to take care of that. So we're going to keep dropping his damage. Frag's going to get 11. Krendoge stacks the bleed on top of the blight. So he's going to be ticking for 9. Yeah, might as well heal. Oh my god, okay. Let's take a step back here for a second, Seth. He's only got 25 dodge. Not a lot. Two dodges in a row is pretty bad. Right, Frag with a good roll of stress heal there on Kate. I'm gonna refresh. No. I'm not. Let's just kill him. There's no reason to. He's gonna die to the dots.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade.
Got a torch. Hey, we got a map. That is better than the trap. That's a good analyzation there, Kate. Okay, so we know it's going to be a while before we have our next fight. We know that it's clear up to the north up here, so there's no reason not to go over there. We can skip this hallway here because let's try that again, team. There we go. We can skip this hallway because we know that there's a shovel and there's nothing. There's literally no reason to be in there other than if we want to waste a shovel. So go ahead and use the herbs and we get more gold.
With loot are often low on supplies.
Yeah, I wouldn't really call that one a pack. It was more of a dead fish, but hey. So this is the room that we can skip if we want to. I'm going to use one of our shovels since we had the good fortune of seeing where one shovel event was going to be. You know, starting to creep down and light a little bit here. Right, Krendor really, really should take the Tide Master out, but leaving the two jellyfish up is kind of scary too because they can do the stuns. But this is the reason why you want to go after the Tide Master. So we do not have a really... We don't have a great way of dealing with stress. So Frag failed the bleed resist. Go ahead and activate riposte on Sept first. I probably should have guarded Kate. Man, Frag is just going nuts today. Failed our stun resist. Go ahead and use a heal here, just to counteract the effects of the bleed, since we can't cure it from Krendor. Wow, Frag is just going ham. Thank goodness for that. Yeah, so I really, really wish that that tanks had a way to taunt in the game. I don't know if that would be overpowered or not, but like, and obviously I know that riposte doesn't mark him, but I kind of wish it did. Gonna cure the bleed on Kate. That way that she's freed up to actually heal now. I'm gonna roll a Cry Havoc. That's okay. It's not the best. I was hoping it would roll on Krendor. Krendor's just gonna get stunned again, so there's that. Alright, except, seriously. And yeah, apparently we're just fighting the Bruce Lee of jellyfish right now. 35 dodge, who knew?
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
So we definitely want to go south here. Oh, proc scouting. We know where. Okay, so we know where the last fights are. We don't have to go here unless if we skip this room, then we have to go there. I mean, honestly, I'm fine with fighting here.
Darkness closes in.
I'm gonna crank a torch just to shed the blackest pitch. We get another torch anyway, so there you go. All right, let's take a look at that new trap mechanic. Well, it's not really new, but 95. No way we can fail that. I'm just gonna see what this curio is. It is a backpack. It's already been looted. Fair enough. I like how the game was still able to get like one little seven stress ding there before we could get through the door. 1500 gold, okay.
Waiting to be spent. Terrors may indeed stalk these shadows, but yonder, a glint of gold.
So we've got plenty of food. We do have a bandage. We could actually burn some food if we wanted to. We know there's gonna be a fight in here. And it's kind of a bad one. We gotta knock out the back line, but the stinger is going to be an issue. And we definitely want to lead off with guard here. From Sept. This is definitely a dog treat fight here. There we go. Nice one shot by Frag.
A faint hope blossoms.
So Sep's gonna get the guard on Kate. That's gonna buff Sep's protection up tremendously. Definitely need a heal here. Frags, no! Didn't get the bleed, unfortunately. Krendor is gonna get the crit dunk, however. So the piranha's dead after basically only one attack, and that's good. Krendor's just gonna keep failing his 80% stun resist. Just because that's just how it goes. Go for the riposte. Man, this is just a slugfest. So there's the barnacle barrier, which we can break with the rampart, although we don't have rampart, so. Nice heal by Kate. Alright. Whenever Krendor feels like not being stunned anymore, let me know. And yeah, there's our disease. So pretty happy about that. I'm gonna mark the champion to drop his protection. You see there, we dropped his protection by 30, and he still has 45% left. That's a lot. Drop his damage by a little bit too. All right, Sept. Apparently, Sept cannot hit the broadside of a barn champion. Dropped his protection by 60%. He's still marked. Let's go ahead and have Krendor cure his bleed and Frag's bleed. And then, yeah, I'll just go for a crush. Got a long way to go on the champion. Should definitely heal here. Alright, let's start burning through that protection here. Protection is completely gone now. There we go, 24 damage. And the champion's actually gonna die from Krendor's bleed. Or, blight, I should say. Yo, Sept, for real though, I know you're British and everything, and I don't know if that has anything to do with your eyesight, but I'm just gonna make a joke and say it does. whatever you got, whatever kind of tea and crumpet you got in your, you got inside your one good eye, you need to get rid of it. We haven't seen that many misses since the last time Maggie did a run. That's no slight to Maggie either, I'm just saying. She doesn't have the greatest of accuracy.
Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
I think we just need crests. Well, actually, apparently we can take everything but two deeds. Good enough. So we opt to go for the harder fight here. We could have just fought that, but there's, of course, a chance that could be the collector. Which is not actually that big of a deal with this
glittering
group.
Gold, trinkets,
okay.
And baubles.
We definitely want blood. The gold and crests as well. So we'll get rid of the anti-venom. And this should be the final fight here. It's going to be the brigand group, which is not that bad at all. He says before nervously throwing out a play grenade and getting destroyed. Let's go ahead and use that last dog treat. And we are going to get the kill on the one off-lethal count it. Go for a guard on Kate. Sep can't miss that, at least.
Unforeseen. Unforgiving.
So slice and dice. Obviously, Sep cannot block AoE. He can block that, though. Kate, we'll just go ahead and offset the bleed here. Brendor's going to keep on working the blight. Frag's going to get the kill. Well, help get the kill anyway. Surprised that the Bloodletter was able to go before anyone else. So there's our AoE crit that we were waiting for. Go ahead and bolster everyone, why not? So we've got to do a lot of stress healing here. So this is going to be all frag, while Krendoge should probably strip the bleed. There we go. Especially on Sep. Sep was bleeding for a lot there. Not the greatest of rolls there, but that's okay. We'll drop the illumination just to get a little bit of torchlight. Go for another guard on Kate. He's another rain of whips. Again is AoE stress, which is not really in our best interest of letting that continue, but probably should cure Sep's bleed actually, but oh well. Nice roll by Frag. Alright, like seriously, this is getting ridiculous. Somebody count how many times Sep has missed. I think it's 5 at this point. If we include the riposte, I think it's 6. Sep actually got moved. that good old Darkest Dungeon numbers. Hey, he finally hit something. It's a Birthmas miracle. Alright.
A victory. Perhaps the turning point.
Get rid of that. We want more gold. Do we need. Yeah, I mean, 250 more gold is not really anything, so that's all right. All right, so fairly easy run. I mean, I'm happy that we get another moon ring, which is the whole reason why we went there in the first place. Surprising amounts of gold, considering that we didn't really get that many curios. So we got 18 Gs in the bank, but we're just gonna... We lost Unerring, and we lost Robust, too. Sweet. Awesome. So we're gonna have to do some disease removal here. Let's see if we got a town event. There was not a town event last time, by the way.
Willful determination sweeps through the barracks.
Okay, so we got Valiant Spirit. They were a fearsome lot. Gritted teeth, distant stares, and between them, an unbreakable bond of fellowship. And the Lord of the Rings. Party gains 15% virtue chance on next quest. Not too bad. I mean, I'll take it. Hopefully we won't ever have to worry about that ever, but it's good to know that we have a better chance at getting a virtuous proc that usually doesn't ever happen ever. So get rid of that. We'll get rid of that. Did Sinvicta get double cured? I think he did. He should have. He better have. Yeah, I got both of them. cool. All right, everyone. Well, I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you for watching again. Sorry about the skipped episode. It wasn't anything special, but I do appreciate all the support here on the channel. If you're seeing this while you're watching in 360 resolution, I promise you, just reload the video and watch it all through again, because you get to see it on glorious high definition. Or don't, if you don't want to. Thank you for watching, everyone. Of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!